Hey church, today we're looking at Psalm 73, a very interesting psalm. The author is Asaph, and what's fascinating about this one is the psalmist is admitting that he has had a very difficult time with bitterness, anger, and envy. And his envy is towards the ungodly people in his culture, people that he has deemed as unrighteous. And he basically is drawing conclusions that nothing bad ever happens to them until death, and that God's people are constantly struggling and are poor and hungry and going through difficulty. But it's that idea of why do the wicked prosper? And he's very angry about it. And anger and bitterness are a strange thing, and because it feels so good at one level to harbor anger and bitterness. But I've heard it said this way, and it's so true, that harboring bitterness is like drinking poison but expecting the other person to die. And you know it's not true, but at the end, it kind of feels good at the beginning, but in the reality is you're killing yourself when you dwell in anger and bitterness and envy. He says so in this psalm, in the first couple of verses. He says, truly God is good to Israel, to those who are in pure, who are pure in heart. But as for me, my foot had almost stumbled. My steps had nearly slipped. It's as if he was about to slip into a great chasm of bitterness and anger. And then he goes on in verses 4 through 20 just to describe all the ways in which the wicked prosper. And I get the sense that he's still working this out, that he's still very upset about all the ways in which the wicked seem to just have a good life. But then ultimately he says this in verse 28, but for me it is good to be near God. I have made the Lord God my refuge, that I may tell of all your works. And I gotta say, right now, man, we are a divided society. We all have strong opinions about what's happening in culture and life and society and politics and all these things. And man, there's a lot of judgment out there, and there's a lot of bitterness, and there's a lot of anger, a lot of divisiveness. And it would be very easy to keep drinking that bitter pill of envy and that bitter pill of bitterness. But I plead with us, church, to look to God's word and to realize there's no wisdom in it whatsoever. At times I feel this close to just staying off Facebook forever. It's almost more than I can bear at times, just to see all the divisiveness. He says in verse 28, but for me, it is good to be near God. I've made the Lord God my refuge, that I may tell of all your works. Ultimately, the Lord is our hope, and the way out of this bitter pill of envy and anger is to look at how much God has forgiven us, to set aside the anger, because God's anger was just to fall on us, but it didn't. Instead, God's mercy fell on us because the anger of God fell on Jesus, and we're cleansed from all of our unrighteousness. We're forgiven of all of our sins. And in light of that, we can be a people that are joyful and that we don't nurse bitterness and an unforgiving spirit. We forgive others because of the great forgiveness we've received in Christ. May God bless you and keep you right now, and guard your heart against the bitterness in these difficult times. May God bless you and keep you, and I'll talk to you soon. Thank you.